I wouldn't even consider a knife. You know, it could be a hook. I call a Filipino knife, the more of a hook, because they're short, and it's designed to hook and cut the arteries. You can't really attack somebody to the heart with that, so you can maybe pop the throat or whatever, but it doesn't have the advantage of a weapon, which is extension. It does have an ease of use. You know, you need to put less force because it's sharp and it has a tip, which can catch and tear artery, but it doesn't have the extension. So in a way, it has the same range of your arms, but without the extra. I mean, you don't really need to shift your weight and all that. You just need to reach the pressure point and cut it. You still need hand-eye coordination, but you have less of a range. So a normal knife is out of the bayonet. That's what you use in the military. You know, you got to use the judgment for whatever you can get. Some of the knives have double edge, some of them don't. It doesn't really matter for slashing, because when you slash, you don't cut with a side. You tear the artery with a tip. You stick the tip, you put the tip on the skin behind it, and as you slash, the tip will tear the artery. So the first hold, it's the hardest. I like to teach the best or the most dangerous attack first. You can teach it the easiest and the hardest. I like to do the other. In case I get cut short, somebody knows how to do the hardest, and it's easier to figure out the rest. So you put the butt of the knife in your palm. Okay? It's on the top. The blade parallel to the ground, so it can pass between the ribs. I don't want it to get stuck. Okay? Down the top, all the fingers on the bottom. Palm up, right? But the butt is sitting in your palm. Okay? From here, you're going to pull the fingers back and push the thumb forward. And make sure that it sits, still sitting here. Okay? Some people will say, well, half the knife, the handle is out. I can grab it. Try to grab it with kind of a focus. You need that in here because when you drive the knife, you can make it push, so it'll go into the wrist, to the heart, or the throat, or you know, the stuff here, the stomach, or anywhere else. And you might have it cold, so you have to go through it. So why is it the most dangerous? Because it has maximum range. You can attack someone without getting close to them. And if you penetrate enough, then it's one step kill. So to be efficient, you stand. I mean, you can stand with any foot you want. You can even stand on your back. But to be most efficient, you stand with the same leg of the knife holding the hand in front. And from about this distance, you can reach him. You know, you wouldn't even believe you can reach him. You know, if you bend here and you basically lunge and use this hand and this leg for balance, because if you don't, then you can't lean more than that. And therefore, you need two steps. But if you lean forward, especially if you set up the one body, you get more distance than one lung. So from here, you pass the target. It comes very quickly and it's hard to defend. If you don't do a pure Krav Maga defense, if somebody stabs like that, you cannot defend. No, nobody else does it. So, put the bottom of the knife in your palm, down on top, pull the fingers on the bottom. Pull the fingers, stick the thumb in front, and push it, make sure it's sitting front. And about 45 degrees, angle to the wall, which is nice. Everybody has that visual corner of the wall. Now, from here, you bend, you lunge, use your arm and leg for balance, then you trap. So you can stab again. Yeah, do it 10 times. Mm-hmm. stand once in a while. Don't get that down. That step to the foot. The shorter step, you have to be closer. They were going to a metal barrel. They were going to hold, but they don't want the shoulder to lose blood by touching it and playing with it. So it's pretty sharp. I mean, you can cut with it. I don't know if you can even cut wood or whatever. But it's not that sharp. You can't go like this, like a ginger knife, and lose a finger. So you need a momentum, for, and plus the slash is not really cutting. It's for the carotid artery. No point. You can also use it for the hand with the impact of the weight. It's very painful. It's a very sharp edge on the bigger area. And maybe you'll get lucky and you have a good cut, and maybe you're lucky and you cut the artery. It all depends. You need a defensive motion. But an attack slash, it's like you want to do all at once, catch everything at once. So if the person's arm were in front of him, protecting or doing something, you got the arm. But you aim for the sword. So to do this, you have to go diagonally. From above the ear to the hip, and then back. You understand over here? Now, I'm holding it in three-finger loose position, and then I'm holding it in all fingers loose position. I'm changing it like this. And I'm letting the tip do the job. So even if you block, you have a little extra here. You know, if you from here, right? You have a chance to reach. You know, the weight of that is enough to get your skin and turn the carotid artery. Same thing on the way back, like here. Right? Here. And here. So you need momentum. So, I mean, the high knife behind your back, or whatever you hold it, but you need to lift it up here over your ear, 45 degrees forward, and bring it down here. Okay? So I'm standing here, from here, and I'm using everything else for balance. So from here, okay, all the way here. Now, the knife is a little loose, and it might hit me here. So I'm moving a little bit extra, so the elbow locks here, and the arm is locked here, it doesn't reach me. Okay. And keep this arm away. Yeah. Don't leave it here. Okay? Now if you escape, you move back, I have another chance. So I move down. Now I'm taking another step and move back. Now, just watch out, from that momentum, you might go Super Mario. You gotta pay attention. And obviously you want a full acceleration. You don't want to slow down the speed. So you can't start slowing down here so you don't do the full march. One way to slow down is to side kick about here. So when I'm doing this, I'm going to do this like here. And it's going to stop you from doing that. So in and then out. Instead of leaving the foot here, just to leave it a little more to the side. Okay, let's do it again. Move after the first one. Okay. Now keep your arms in front. Okay. From here. No, look in front. Extend it from here. Okay. From here. One. At this point, the blade is not going to be parallel to the ground. It's going to be here. Why? If I'm stabbing top down, it's going to go to the clavicle. Right here. And if I'm turning, it's going to go to the rib, so it's going to be parallel to the ground. So here it's going to be parallel to the rib. But over here it's going to go to the clavicle. If some people stab like this, he's going to bleed, but it's not going to reach the heart. You know, you need a lot of stabs or you'll bleed a lot. It's still not going to die. It's going to be shock and pain and all that. More chance if. And again, if you're doing this, it's going to get caught in the rib. You need to go straight. And it's easier to do with this, and it's more distant. So if somebody's stabbing your chest with a top-down hole, it's a top-down hole, but it's a straight stab because it's going to the front of your body. And an inefficient one. So if somebody's stabbing here, you're not going to block from the top, you got to block something that's coming in front. So it's called an inefficient straight stab. Anything that comes here, it has less strength than what it should be. And then we have bottom up. So normally, top down, the most efficient, optimal way is to step with the opposite foot and stab in the rear. All right, you run, right? From here, you get close, and then you stop. It's easier for balance and aiming. Not that you cannot do it this way. You don't mean you can run like this. You can do it that way. Okay? If you miss, you know, you hit your back. Over here, you have more control.
Balance up.
And you have more force, yeah. Bottom up, you grab it on the bottom. And in the Arab market, they have a knife that is a little bit curled in here. It's for mostly for belly stuff. People actually use their arm like a pendulum, and they just walk or run in front of each other, and then move to the side and stab here, like that. Okay, stab, pull it up. If you pull it up, you pull the intestine down. It's not going to die on the spot, but it's going to die pretty soon. It's slow down. Okay? And their knife is like, not even steel, it's like copper, but they're pretty sharp and it's dangerous. So that's why maybe they go to the belly, because it's not strong enough to pass the bone. Yeah, homemade or whatever. So from here, even here. And obviously you can run in with all these and do that. So it's the bottom up. So, and if somebody's doing bottom up like this from here, we consider it as a straight step because it's reaching the front. Only it's shorter. Right? It is shorter. So we treat it as a straight step. Why? Because straight step, as you move in, you feel the blade. Circular step, first you move in and then the blade is coming. Now, that bottom up, you use a pendulum of motion when you attack. I mean, the whole thing is going like this, right? You add to it also up and down swing, like a pulley. And that helps to stop any resistance.
Right.
He's going to block it, right? Okay? Okay? We do a couple of times. All right, so we're going to practice stop down. I'm going to step with the opposite foot and mark the carotid artery, and then I'm going to mark the side. Obviously, if somebody comes from this side, you can attack that way with a top down hold. You can also hit with a butt of the knife to the temple. You can also hit him here. Why you want to do that? I don't know. Maybe if he's too close or you have a couple of opponents, you know, you give the first hit or whatever. Just you know, keep in mind it's an option. Okay? And obviously, from here, right, you can also, if somebody's close, you can cut that way. If it's sharp or whatever. Otherwise, you just have a big scratch or whatever. There might be a couple. Okay? So from your top down, and from here, you know, you can also do this, and that. This is still top down. Okay? And bottom up. From here, or side. Yeah, some people want to do like that, you know. Takes too long. It's like inefficient top down. It takes forever to reach that. I mean, this is top down from here. It'll take forever to get here. This one, you know, you gotta somehow get to it. It's distracting. So try that. Yeah, try to stop the knife.
Right?
Okay.
we have two knives?
A pistol, we do it two at a time.
This is a bloody knife, mate.
Just a little bit of drill just so you get an idea. It's mostly attacks. It means they really have no defense. If somebody, it's all about the first cut. If you get cut, then it slows your mind down a little bit and you continue. I don't know if you can get your artery torn and your both arms still, you know, continue to grind your opponent. In the movie, it works, but not in reality. In reality, the little step here, right after the knife is being pulled, the person is not John Wick. The person drops down and you can't move. It's like getting a Valium pill in the doctor's office before surgery. He's totally done. But in the movie, you know, you see somebody take all your muscles out, tendons and everything, and you're still fighting. If you're on drugs or whatever, you don't feel anything. You use each part separately. Right? So we got to hold the knife like this top down. Now, you know, we have two knives, okay? So you can still use the method of attack you did before and have the other knife as spare, like a backup pistol. So, I mean, I can attack from here to this, and if something happens, I mean, I don't know, we grab my knife or whatever, then I'm going to use the other one as a backup. I still have the advantage of a maximum range. But if I want to use both knives in pretty close timing, I need to stand with both hands in front. You know, I can't like extend that much. I have to be shorter. If I want to attack from a different direction in pretty close timing, you know, if I extend too much, then it's not going to be. Even in boxing, you know, it's like a little shorter. Using the confusion from all directions. The only problem is you're already in a hot zone, and when you're out of the hot zone, the first punch when you enter in gives you a determination if you have a chance to finish the fight or not. Obviously, if you skip that chance, then it starts again. And you can exchange punches forever until somebody get a knockout. But if I'm standing here, we're gonna do a drill of slashing and cutting. So I'm gonna start down, like figure eight, and with the other one, okay? Bam, in here. I'm going to do this, figure eight with both hands, okay? And then I'm going to do stabbing. So I'm going to come here, slash, stab, and slash, right? Combined with stabbing. Once in a while it's going to be a slash and a stab, right? Come here, stab, here, and here, okay? So you just move forward, imagine figure eights, shamrocks, imagine whatever you want to do, carving. Just try to use both knives without cutting yourself and trying to increase your speed. And your opponent obviously will move back in circles.
When you're moving forward, are you advancing normal with a walking normal, or do you use your stand on here?
You can move in there, you can walk. Either walk or do the gallop. And if he's coming top down, you're gonna do this. Okay? Military, I don't know, whatever. Either that or you're gonna use it somehow, that tactic. But this is a drill. He's coming bottom? Yeah, okay.
Bottom up?
No. Yeah, whatever. Here? In here. Straight? Here? In here. And over here, you don't really need to move because you have the extension. So it's from the spot. Everything is from the spot. Okay? From the spot. Go or not. You're wasting time walking and then you're doing something. The slash you need to. Either neck, it's harder to step. If you step, it's harder to defend. You don't look there. You look straight, you see the whole picture. And from here, right? You aim right here, like you can. And if I see, if he's faster, he's coming, you need to escape. Right? Now, you can do this and step immediately. So here, nick and step. Nick and step. Now, if you need to drop your knife, He's coming here, right? And he could drop it, you know, so grab him down there and step. Sit out of the top. Up in there. He's coming here, I'm taking it down, grabbing. And he's going for that hand, not going for your body. At the same time, I'm doing this. Okay? So try it. We'll do two people and we can rest. I don't know, 2-3 minutes. Okay? So, defense against is great stuff. Obviously, you don't want to, you see somebody or not, you don't want to do that. He wants to cut your throat or your stomach. If you see the arm, he's afraid you're going to get it, so he's going to go for your hand first. He's become a target. Now, if he's cutting your hand and you try to evade, and your hands are down, he can continue to stab you. So he wastes your time. Okay? Go ahead. So, it's very fast. You know, you might think you're seeing it slow, but it's very fast. You don't have time to move your body. When you want to do alignment below your forearm with this wrist. So right now it's about here, so I need to do adjustment with my knee. Right now, my belt forearm is against his wrist. If he's standing a little higher, if it comes from my throat, I don't need to use my knee. But as you move, you need to adjust with your knees. And all you do is just adjust with your knees, aim the belly of your forearm through his wrist, and you don't hit him. You get close, and then you flip your thumb out, and then this goes past your sternum, and the knife is out of the reach. So this is the first move, okay? Then you have to do a couple more things before you're going to try to do a second step, which is going to be very quickly. All you have to do is drop and try again. You can also cut on the way back. Okay? So from here again. Next step, okay. Now you try and look. Okay. Here. You stay here. Okay, and you put pressure because he's going to reach you here. Now, if I did it like this, it will slide. If I caught it in the edge or here, it's dangerous. So if I aim in the middle, maybe if I miss a little bit, it's still going to be close to the center foot. Okay? Now, after I did this, right, he might pull back, jump back, and try to attack again. And he could follow him. If he retracts again, if he retracts, he might be here. It's okay. I want to put this on his wrist again. So it depends on where he is. I'm moving as far as I can here. Right? Now, step again. Okay, again. Okay? I don't need to go. He's here. He's going to move back. But you put your foot next to him. Okay? From here, you flip it back. Push with the elbow here. You don't want to do a leverage on your wrist, but get comfortable. Next to the arm, push it here, and you punch. Punch once. He's resistant. You go with him. You punch two. Boom, boom. And then you come here, grab a two-hand kick, and extract. Make sure before you kick, this leg goes behind. So I take him out of balance. So when I kick, he's not going to pull me if I put his foot come down before I finish this kick. Okay, so grab here, punch, bring it here, close to your body. This is a throttle, motorcycle throttle, this is a faucet, grab it here. Okay, now I'm going to do this and this, now I'm with my hand with my body. If this foot comes behind and I'm pulling, and now I'm kicking. Now, you don't want to start doing this. If I'm doing this, you can pull, escape. Pull your hand. Pull. Okay? Now I'm going to pull it when I'm going to lift it up. Okay? Keep it here instead of grabbing all your weight on it. Okay, from here. Okay. Here you hit. And then you can. Okay, you know, if you still have this, then you're going to pull that way. You know, kick. Now, the tissue and knife extraction. Dig your fingers, roll your fingers, and dig them in. You shouldn't have a problem. It's almost like a corn snatch. You hit him enough, you kick him enough, and then if the knife is not on the floor, You just take it out. Okay, and then you slash all the way up. So let's do that training step first. Stand on the line. You don't walk. Just relax, relax. Like this. And slide. Attention, attention. Attention. Don't walk around. Relax and slide like that. And then move in.
So, it has so much momentum, it'll hurt whatever it is.
won't be able to use that arm again. He come here, right? Come here, right? So he can pull. This is why I don't try. Over here, if I pull, I still have nothing. But, you know, if I'm locked, because I have to come closer. Over here, I don't get to come closer. It's just a tip. So you don't try to block. You just move away from the first one. You have to evade it. Yeah, if somebody playing around and doing stuff like that, you treat it like a step. You move in. It's still within a reasonable range. You know, you can come here, here, here. If I'm doing like this, you know, you treat it like a straight step. Yeah. But over here, I have momentum, and it's coming in speed. So you forget about the first one. Now we're going to do outside. So I forget about the first one. Come here. Now, I just did this, right? Now, obviously, I hit him, right? And I would, at the beginning, you're worried more about that. So you want impact with both hands, not just one and one. That. But you see, almost like the defense four here, right? And now you want to wrap your arm, if you can, around him like this, over the elbow. Not only that, and you want to apply pressure. He might be able to poke you a little bit in the skin. You might not, but if you hold it tight, it's fine, right? I actually lock my arm here. I mean, you can do that. You know, you can hit him here, you know, knee him, stop on his foot, grab his foot, right? You can throw him like that. You know, he might fight you or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Extract. Oh.
I'll change that. Okay.
Okay, and attacking with the opposite hand.
Opposite, okay.
So you're putting your feet, not your hips. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. No, you still. Keep the other leg in front. That's good.
That's awesome.
What'd you do?
It's fantastic.
One hand or two hands?
He was just massaging me.
Oh, listen.
Here.
Talk about this. Look how he's supposed to hold these. There you go. Okay. You're coming in. You've got a burger taking a hit. You've got two hands. Yeah, you can.
Can you do
it? Just do it. Yes, you can. Okay?
Do it then.
Do it.
Help him out. Let him know.
Take him out of bounds before you lift your foot for a kick. I don't know if I said it 20 times, but if I say it 21, you're in bad shape.
I don't know.
Okay. And it's good.
That's good. Marcus,
are we good? Are we good?
No, we're good.
Okay. You're turn, you lost my neck.
Okay. So we did bottom up, lying on the other side. Okay. Then we're going to do top down. And after that, now don't forget, we're going to do this trapping hand. So top down. If I want to move to his dead side, I'm going to be standing actually on the side, not in neutral position. So forget about the light side, dead side. You have no say when you're going to do it. The most important thing, you start from a neutral position because we did all the rest from neutral position. So I'm going to start from neutral position. Okay, now I'm actually going to be on the left side. Now, you know, some people, if you used to teach it like this, go ahead, lock and hit, and then straight. Some people used to do all kind of motorcycle stuff. I prefer, go ahead, swing first, and then hit. And because if he's coming at fake, and he's coming here, right, I'm coming here, even if I punch it, I'm probably going to get it, and I'm going to get something. So, if fake, there's no resistance, he's coming pretending, and it's lying here. So you need to, you can't even catch it, you need to follow him with your arm and keep pushing forward so the stab here is going to be in front. Do it again. In here. Okay, go ahead. In here. Okay. So I'm going to do a circle here with the elbow here and in front. Okay, this is safer. If you're sure you're going to stab you here, you do this and then you push, you grab here and you do that. But you can't be sure. And over here, you're flat like this. From here, okay. Now if I'm standing with my back, I'm going to go to his that side. From here, I'm going to come here and finish it the same thing that we did the slap. Why? After you lock, right? He can stab you here. So you want to be away, right? Okay. Okay. Go here, one, and then. Okay, try both. 10 times, please. Right? You don't want to. Go ahead. Okay? The same finish as the other. You don't want somebody to put his hand on you when he has a knife, even if he doesn't. So, before he puts his hand on you, go ahead, you slap it. And now his hand is up, you want to slap it here, but if his hand is down, hold it on, no, hold it on here, and then you want to slap it here. Just so mentally, he's going to be careful not to cut himself. And right after you slap him, go ahead. You slap him, you move here and grab. Right? Slap, move here, and grab this one with this. And the same thing here and here. Now, what he could do, he sees that you slap his hand. Go ahead. No, okay. 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 He can now move over here and stab you. Okay? Because I'm trying to get his back. Let's do it again. I do this. No, don't let me get your back to move away. Stop on your hand. Go ahead, stop on your hand. Okay. Okay, can we do this? Again, stop on your hand. Okay. Okay. So do this, right? Now you're just going to come here. Okay. Right? Because when he moves, he's not attacking. He's repositioning himself. He doesn't do it at the same time. Okay? Okay? I heard a big thing. like a pot. Right? So the idea is to get behind his back. Go ahead. I do this. If I can, I do this. If I can, then I do that. Okay. Okay. When he moves in, you know, instead you want to deal with one at a time. So I'm standing here. Go ahead. You want to move here and do the same thing. Okay.
Yep.
And if you move back, you kick. Basically.
Okay.
Go ahead. Go ahead. Okay, just burst forward by two hands at that. If you're there, you can kick him over.
You should have come down with that.